Hello, this is the mid-September weather and climate outlook update for grain-growing regions of South Australia, Victoria and Tasmania. This outlook will focus on rainfall and temperature, including frost, in the next weeks and months to support upcoming decisions. First, the key messages, and soil moisture levels are average to below average for grain-growing regions across all the three states. Soil moisture levels are expected to decline further into October, especially for some parts of South Australia. Below median rainfall continues to be the expectation in the next weeks to months, and in terms of temperature, we are still expecting above median daytime and nighttime temperatures, but frost does remain a risk for the next month or so. Looking now at soil moisture conditions, and they do very much reflect the dry month of September to date. We're about halfway through the month, but almost all grain-growing areas across the three states have seen less than half the average rainfall, as September is typically one of the wetter months for southeastern Australia. Rainfall totals have ranged from between 15 to 30 millimetres in the lower and mid-north of South Australia to less than 10 millimetres for parts of the Upper Eyre Peninsula. We've also seen less than 10 millimetres through the Victorian Mallee, but in contrast, more than 30 millimetres for some pockets of Tasmania to the east of Launceston, but further south, less than 15 millimetres at Campbelltown. Into October, all remaining pockets of average soil moisture is expected to dip to below average. This is particularly the case through the Victorian and South Australian Mallee and towards the Wimmera, and also southwest Victoria and southeast South Australia. But we do see more significant deficits developing around the Eyre Peninsula and some areas around Adelaide and towards Murray Bridge. Looking now at the 10-day accumulated rainfall, comparing the EC model on the left and the access model on the right, out to Wednesday, the 20th of September. And over the coming 10 days, as you can see here, there's very little significant rainfall for South Australia and Victoria. The only areas expecting more than 2 millimetres are southeast South Australia and southwest Victoria, potentially southern parts of the Wimmera. But further west and north for locations like Kimber, Mildura and Kerrang, there's really nothing on the forecast at this stage over the next 10 days. In Tasmania, we're still expecting showers in the north of the state, and particularly as you can see here in the access model, but this rainfall you see here is due later in the 10-day outlook, so confidence is low at this stage. If we look towards the last 2 weeks or so of September, looking at the chance of above median rainfall, as you can see, it is looking to be a dry end to the month. Past accuracy is moderate, with about 55 to 65% accuracy based on past performance, but this declines to be less than 50% through parts of South Australia. However, it does look like the model can be trusted at this stage. That's because for the last week or so of September, we are expecting a strong ridge of high pressure to develop over the Bight and the Southern Ocean, and this will act as a bit of a block for rain-bearing systems coming through from the west. For October, and looking again at the chance of above median rainfall, it is again painting a picture of a drier than average month, and past accuracy is moderate to high across parts of the three states. If we extend our outlook now from November to January 2024, we do see that for parts of northern Victoria and eastern South Australia, the access model is currently indicating about a 50-50 chance of seeing above median rainfall. And this is also complemented by reasonable past accuracy. To confirm this, we can also look at some international models. And looking here at a blend of the US, European, Japanese and Canadian models, it's also showing the chance of seeing above median rainfall, and similar to access, it's painting that 50-50 picture the further north you go. So that'll really be one watch point heading into the summer. A look at frost now, and we are on the lookout for some cooler mornings from Sunday the 17th of September, particularly through parts of northern Tasmania where frost is a risk, but through Victoria and South Australia, although we do see some cooler mornings into early next week, temperatures don't really dip below 6 degrees, and so the risk of frost is fairly low. We do, however, see a possible increased risk in the following week. On the next slide, what we're seeing here is an experimental map. The chance of seeing at least one frost or below 2 degrees in the week of the 22nd of September on the left-hand side, and then the fortnight of the 22nd of September on the right-hand side. what you can see here is that there is still at least a 10 to 40 and even 70% chance of seeing a frost in the last week of September and into the first week of October. If you extend looking our outlook, looking at the chance of above median minimum temperatures, we do see quite a significant change from the last outlook in that we are seeing a higher chance of warmer nights, so less risk of frost is indicated compared to the previous outlook. But what we did see before, that frost is still a risk, and that's especially due to these clear nights overnight. Looking at maximum temperatures now, and we are expecting to see above median maximum temperatures across the board, and accuracy is very high for that time of year from October to December. And looking now at the chance of seeing unusually high maximum temperatures, so this is the maximum temperatures in the top 20% of historical figures. We can see here there's at least about three to four times more likely to see temperatures in that top 20%, and also very good accuracy as well. So it is pointing towards an abnormally warm end to spring and early summer. And finally, in the last update, we did show this pattern here, which shows the chance of seeing, or the anomaly of sea level pressure from the average. What it's showing here is that we are likely to see through spring more high pressure to the south of the country. And for the southeast of the country, this can mean fewer rain-bearing systems coming through from the west, but it also does put Victoria, South Australia and Victoria in a little bit more of a southerly to easterly wind regime as well. So this can help to explain the pattern of drier conditions that we're expecting heading into the summer. That's it for this Grains Climate Outlook. We'd love to hear more from you, so scan the QR code on your screen now or visit the website to fill in a short survey about the video and send through any other feedback. Thanks for watching.